Hey guys, welcome back to 11 Cups. And in this week's episode, I want to give you guys my thoughts on the Willsence kettle, which if you guys remember, we unboxed this just about a month ago. And I've been using this kettle for my daily pourovers. I know a lot of you guys been waiting for the final thoughts on this kettle. I just want to make sure I cover as much points about this kettle as possible. So therefore the testing took a little bit longer. But nonetheless, I think I finally have a complete picture for you guys. And here it is, the review on the Willsence kettle. So before we jump into the review, I want to let you guys know again that I picked this kettle because I wanted to test out a more budget-friendly option compared to the fellow EKG, which was what I was using before I got the Willsence. So after doing some research and some reviews, I find the Willsence to tick a lot of the boxes that the fellow EKG had. And in terms of aesthetics, I thought it looked very nice as well. So with that said, keep in mind, whatever I feel about Willsence, I am definitely comparing this against the fellow EKG, which is a kettle that costs twice as much as the Willsence. So with that out of the way, I've broken down today's review into five different points. We'll be judging the Willsence based on its speed, function, temperature hold, aesthetics, and lastly, the handling. So first, let's talk about the speed. In terms of boiling straight out of tap water to my desired 205 degrees Fahrenheit, both the Willsence and the fellow EKG performed very, very similarly. Especially during my daily use, I did not feel that the Willsence was any slower than the fellow EKG. However, during my last video of the unboxing, I actually did a live speed comparison. So if you have not seen that video yet, I will leave the links to that video down below in the description. In that video, we did notice that the fellow EKG is ever so slightly faster than the Willsence. But again, it's not something that I'm noticing unless if I'm comparing them side to side. In terms of function, both the Willsence and the fellow EKG are actually very, very similar. And that is actually one of the reasons why I picked this kettle in the first place. They both have a built-in timer function, as well as a selectable temperature, and of course the temperature hold function. But one feature that the Willsence have that I do appreciate over the fellow EKG is that it does have the option to turn on and off a beeping function where it will notify you once the water is done boiling. So this actually turned out to be quite handy whenever I decided to walk away from the kettle to do something else, only to forget that I was boiling water. So the beeping sound is a good reminder that my water is ready. However, both the built-in timer on the fellow as well as the Willsence work very similarly. Essentially, you press the timer button, it's gonna have a 3-second countdown, and then the timer will start. I do find this style of timer to be not that easy to use in my opinion, so I do recommend that for either one of these kettles, you either get a scale with the timer built in or just use your phone as a timer. I do want to point out something that I said about the fellow EKG, which was that it will not remember the last temperature you set it at. This is the same case with the Willsence. In order for both of these kettles to remember the exact temperature that you set it at the last time, you do need to keep them plugged in, which most of the time after boiling the water, I like to just keep them unplugged and placed away. So unless if you guys like to keep your kettle plugged in at all times, you just need to remember to set the temperature every single time you turn the kettle on, which to be honest I thought was a inconvenience in the beginning, but I soon got used to just doing that every single time. Alright, so there's actually one more thing that I really appreciate about the Willsence kettle that the fellow EKG does not have, which is this retractable cord system on the bottom of the base. Even though both of these cords aren't that long, but having this built into the base of the Willsence kettle does make cord management easier. So to follow up with the topic of function, I want to specifically take the temperature hold function out as a separate topic because I wanted to see if there was actually a difference in terms of temperature accuracy. And for this, I'm going to take out my fellow EKG. So over the past month that I was using the Willsence, I would measure its hold temperature every single time that I was making coffee. As a matter of fact, I ended up breaking the thermometer because of how much moisture I was exposing it to. But anyways, that's not the point here. The thing that I did notice is that the fellow is always very consistent in terms of bringing the temperature back up to exactly where you wanted it. Whereas the Willsence would typically be about 1 to 1.5 degrees Fahrenheit off. Which means if you wanted to hold your water at about 205, so the fellow will always bring it back up to just over 205, whereas the Willsence will say that it brought it back up to 205. However, when you measure it, it's usually around 203.5 to about 204. Now, knowing this, you can simply get the kettle and set the hold temperature to about 1 to 2 degrees over whatever your desired hold temperature is. However, there is a limitation in terms of the hold function on the Willsence. The Willsence's temperature hold function will only work below 206 degrees Fahrenheit, which means my normal pourover temperature is already at its max range. So therefore, over the past month, I was basically making a pourover with a 204 degree water. So whether or not this little limitation will affect you, it will really depends on how hot you like to keep your water. And of course, without testing out multiple units, I would not be able to definitively tell you that every single Willsence will behave this way. Maybe I simply got a fluke, but it is something definitely noteworthy to keep in mind. Okay, now when it comes to aesthetics, I think this will generally comes down to more of a personal preference. The Willsence is just overall rounder. It's got a rounder base, a rounder body, and even the spout shape is definitely a bit more curvier than that on the fellow EKG. And of course, the EKG on the other hand is just overall more edgy. The base is a straight up square. The kettle itself, it's got more defined edges on it. Even the spout have more of a straight defined look to it. And of course, whichever one of these shapes you prefer, that is completely up to you. Besides the overall shape, there is a clear advantage that the fellow have over the Willsence, which is that everything about the fellow EKG just feels more premium. Again, keep in mind, this kettle does cost double of this one. So when I say premium, I mean that in terms of body, the fellow's got more of a unibody look to it. The Willsence, you can definitely see the connection between the base and the kettle, and of course even the spot where the spout comes out. Fellow just got one simple button on the front, one simple screen, of course the two toggles on the back of the unit, versus the Willsence decided to keep the two buttons out front, and of course this dial overall just feels less premium than the dial that is on the fellow EKG. Now, when I was talking about the fellow EKG before, I mentioned that there was a groove inside the kettle that helped getting out as much water out of the kettle as possible. So it's only fair to mention that the Willsence also have that groove. Although it's not as deep and lack the little piece of metal screen that the fellow have, I still find that this does a pretty good job at getting as much water out of the kettle as possible. Now lastly, I wanted to go over the handling. The fellow is definitely the clear winner over the Willsence, and as a matter of fact, I prefer the fellow's handling over any other kettle that I have used. The overall weight distribution on the fellow is just much more balanced, and with this handle design, it's definitely more ergonomic to hold, especially when you're making your pour. And of course, the design of the spout is much more restrictive, and therefore helps you a lot when it comes down to slowing your pores. Now, that is not to say that the Willsence is completely uncomfortable to use. As a matter of fact, if I have never used the fellow before, I'll probably think the Willsence work just fine when it comes to making pourovers. Over the 4 weeks I was using this kettle, I did get used to the overall handling of this kettle, and I was able to manually slow down my pour just by controlling the angle of which I'm pouring. Now, coming back to the fellow at the end of that 4 weeks just makes me appreciate everything about the fellow EKG that much more. However, there's actually just one thing that I do like on the Willsence. Due to its handle design, whenever I'm pouring, my thumb is actually nowhere near this burning hot metal ring. Whereas on the fellow EKG, if you're holding it the way that it's meant to be held, your thumb is actually constantly next to that metal ring. And for someone who actually have a bigger hand or even like a bigger thumb, I am pretty sure it would be even more noticeable. Alright guys, to sum it up, I think the Willsence is actually a very, very capable kettle. During the past month that I was using it, I honestly enjoyed using it a lot more than I thought I would. The biggest point that I would take off the Willsence is really the temperature sensor issue. I'm not sure if every copy of the kettle will come out of the factory with the same variability. However, the whole point of having a temperature hold function is that you hope it is accurate. So if you're thinking about getting this kettle, I would say to just test out the temperature on your own and see if your copy have this issue. If it does, and you prefer to brew your coffee at 205 degrees Fahrenheit, then maybe the Willsence is not for you. However, if you're fine with brewing your coffee at 203, 202, 201, then you will simply adjust the temperature to be 1 to 2 degrees higher, and you'll be perfectly fine. I always like to be very cautious when I'm recommending a premium product, just because when something is more expensive, chances are it's going to come with some premium features that the cheaper or more budget-friendly options wouldn't have. And in this particular comparison, if handling is of the utmost importance to you, I believe the fellow EKG have the best handling of any kettle out there. If you don't want to pay this much for a kettle, I think the Willsence is perfectly fine. Would I say the fellow EKG is twice as good as Willsence? Probably not. But where Willsence do a lot of things good, The Fellow just do a lot of things great. With that said, if your budget allows the Fellow EKG, I think you'll be perfectly happy with it. However, if you're not looking to spend $150 on a coffee kettle, I think the Willsence will suit your needs just fine. Anyways, I hope this video helped answer the questions that you guys might have. I try to cover everything that I could think of in regards to the Willsence kettle. If I missed anything, you can feel free to let me know in the comment section down below. And also tell me, what kettle are you currently using and what you like about them? And maybe I'll have a chance to test them out. And as always, if you're new to the channel, please support us by giving us a like and of course a subscribe. We did launch our Instagram page just about a week ago, and you can find us on Instagram just by typing in XICups or via the link on our YouTube banner. Anyways, that is it for this episode, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Bye.